Waiting on our Uber.
Yeah, Uber.
It's gonna be here soon.
Oh my goodness, it's so late. I can't wait 2 minutes. He just gotta find a car.
I got a booger? What?
No, yeah, he's got a booger.
Yeah.
Fancy seeing this guy here. We're like the only Montanas here, so.
Yeah, this is the Montana section right here.
Yes. Yeah. Very seclusive. Well, we made it to the hotel, and it's a pretty big hotel. But yeah, it was a very long trip. We made it here, and we're happy to be here. And we're gonna connect with a couple people. Probably go grab a bite to eat first. And Nick and I are sharing a room. That's scary. Haven't done that since, like, I don't know, when we were kids. But whatever.
There's a lifestyle here that we live that's not being told and not being shared to the world. And every one of us has a totally different world we're living in, but we're all in the same roots. We're all in the same boat. We all deal with the same environmental conditions and whatnot. And the disconnect between the producer and the consumer has just grown to a point where now there's a vacuum, and it's our opportunity to fill that vacuum.
I could get used to this right here. I think this button here is the
pew 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 pew
pew pew pew pew pew pew pew pew pew.
So they put up this wall over here so they can't see what's on the other side. We can totally see what's on the other side. Looks like a lot of junk.
Right over there.
Let's go ahead and step up inside the Case Quadtrac 500.
So they redid the cabin here. It's just super nice in here, guys. It's like really nice. I like this little kick plate that they got over here on the feet. So every time you come in with your boots, you don't like tear up the plastic, you don't scratch it. They've got a nice de-throttle right here. They made a lot of changes in here that I think is a lot better than the original style that they had. It just seems a lot nicer. They got nice compartments up here. They got a nice screen over here to tell what's going on with your engine. I don't believe it's a touch screen because you have your touch screen right here, but yeah, this is very nice. Oh, I like that. Ram mounts. Now, one of the things that's really nice is the convenience of having everything at your fingertips here. So when you're actually turning a corner or you're trying to do something crucial and you don't want to focus a lot of time on the monitor and the screen so you don't like run into something, you can set this up to different commands on the joystick. And I believe there's like about 30 some commands that you can have up on this joystick. So everything's right here. The technology that they've got today is just phenomenal. I mean, they've got so many nice, wonderful things about making our lives easier and more convenient. Now, it's going to take a little learning curve to try to understand a little bit of this, but honestly, I think it's a pretty simple system. I love the fact that they got USB ports just around in here, because anymore, everything runs off as USB, so it's kind of a nice feature. Oh, that's kind of sweet. They even have little controls to adjust your mirrors up here, which is actually really sweet. So if you're driving down the road and you want to adjust the mirror a little bit further out, like to see the auger on the grain cart, or if you wanna, you're passing traffic, you can adjust that. That's kind of sweet, actually. This is super nice. Seats are comfy. Oh, man, they're so comfy. And the buddy seat's actually pretty decent, too.
Well, I'm sitting in a mock-up version of the cab of the new Steiger, also in the mid-range tractors. Very similar setup. They've changed a lot of the features in here to make it easier, but it's extremely programmable to whoever's gonna run it. You can set all the switches and adjustments that you use for an individual person. Often you can pre-program them into four buttons or more. So you can just do a one button tap and accomplish a task like a headland turn, raising the implement. You can set the time of that raise and then the time of the tractor will slow down, shift down to gear. And you make the turn, you hit the button, it will pick the speed up, let the implement down in its exact amount of seconds. So every turn is consistent. And so fully programmable, beautiful screen, nice and bright, in all kinds of daylight. Has camera features that hooks up so you can see around you, you can set the different cameras. Ergonomics of the chair is awesome. You've got a dual throttle here, where you can preset for certain types of applications. So you have a low and a high here. So you can set it, it'll be at a certain speed, or you can pre-program and then have different switches depending on your going up a hill or through a low spot or something. You can just hit it, it'll pre-program down. The Steiger has got where you can keep a constant speed. The engine will vary depending on the engine, the torque load of what the implement pulling it. So you can just keep that speed and the efficiency of whatever the engine is the best efficiency for acres per gallon. You can have that set. So a lot of optional features that weren't available on the others are now available because of the enhancement of the screen. So there are just multitudes of things that are just really nice. So it's going to take more than this old dog to learn them in a couple minutes, but to the younger folks, they adapt so easy to this, and it's just awesome. I think they've done a great improvement.
For those that didn't know, we actually ran one of these Underfirth grain carts. Now, it was a 1620, I believe it was, and it was a tandem wheel or inline wheel. It didn't have steerable axles, but it was an amazing cart. We got to run that with the Case IH Steiger. Awesome. It was so much fun. First grain cart we've ever had on our farm, and Underfirth was very generous and let us demo one. It was awesome. For those that don't know, we actually have this system on both of our air drills. Intelligent Ag came out with it. We've had it for a couple years and it's been phenomenal. If you ever have a rock stuck in your boot, or if you have a plug on your air drill somewhere, or like your fertilizer bridges, you're running out of seed, you'll know exactly when it starts to not have as much product going through the tubes. Phenomenal system. I don't think I would ever run an air drill without this system. It is one of the most amazing systems for blockage, because the problem is if you start seeding, let's just say you seed about 500 acres and you've got one run on your air drill that's plugged. Well, after 500 acres, that adds up a lot. And every time you scratch the ground and you don't put a seed in the ground,
there's a potential for weeds. So you have to have a competition with the weeds. Well, whatever you're putting in the ground in that row, it will actually compete with the weeds and you won't have as many weeds. Now, if it just digs the row, doesn't put seeds down because the tube is blocked, you'll have weeds come up and it's just an issue. So you lose product, well, you actually gain more weeds and it's just kind of a hassle. So this system here, guys, is phenomenal. I would highly recommend if you have an air drill and you want to get a blockage system, check these guys out. Well worth it. You know, one of these days, I hope that I get to run one of these, a Patriots. I think that would just be awesome. Like, I've always seen these things run around. Many, many people around us have these. I've always heard that this is the best sprayer on the market, and I would love to run one someday, but you never know. What do you think, Dad? Should we sell the Brute and get a Patriot?
I think we ought to cancel our paint tickets and I'll road this home.
Yeah, that's not a bad idea. He can cancel his plane ticket and he can road it home, and I'm gonna go ahead and head home, so. But yeah, we'll see you next spring.
Let's see, I better take off now.
Yeah,
all right, you better see you guys. Okay, let me get this program, Shelby. Time of arrival. Let's see here, it's the 27th, 28th, March 2. Okay, we'll be there.
You guys might recognize this name. For those that watch our channel and you know about the 9370 International Truck, the one that we kind of went through and restored, they are the ones that made our grain trailer. We love that aluminum grain trailer, the 42 foot. So thank you, Demco.
Awesome.
It's been a pleasure.
Guess what, guys? I found this guy. You remember him?
Are we going to do an arm wrestling or is it leg wrestling? Because I don't know which one it's supposed to be.
I'm not good at either, so
we'll
do the best of three on both.
We're going to try three? Man, this guy's ambitious. I don't think I'm that ambitious. But anyways, guys, if you haven't checked out his channel, Farmhand Mike, awesome guy. He's actually a big guy in real life, kind of like me, so I can relate. We like food, so if you want to take us out to eat someplace, we'd love that. But this is awesome.
Yep.
Get to connect with a lot of different people. And any words of wisdom?
Nope. It was awesome coming out to your guys' farm last year. It was a great visit.
Came out last year?
Yeah, don't you remember? I stopped by the farm. I was telling you guys how great I was.
We had therapy. We thought we removed it.
I blocked that from my memory just because it was just so tragic. I mean,
you guys made me feel at home because I thought I was going to be there like 2 hours and it was like dark. And you guys are begging me to stay, although you tell everyone you were trying to get me to leave.
But you're making us feel really like we're needy, like we... Well, we kind of were, actually.
I felt like family there.
We didn't want to see your beautiful face go. I mean, like, this guy here, he's a farmhand, so we wanted him to stick around and help us out a little bit. Yeah. But guess what? He had to leave later on, but you did get on the road.
I had a good time, and I got to see that one awesome piece of farm equipment you guys have never showed on your YouTube channel, and I featured it on my Instagram and my YouTube, so everyone got to see your old full-type slaughter.
If you guys really want to have a great friend, we will show you the piece of equipment that we have that he wants, and if you buy it, he'll come to your place and be your best
friend.
Here's
a picture of him riding it.
Guess what, guys? I'm actually here at the Case IH booth, and I'm running into a few people that you might know. Do you know these ladies? They're very nice and very, very sweet. Just saying. So this is...
Meredith Bernard. This farm wife is my channel.
And I'm Tara, Beaver Vineyards.
And you can find these two on Instagram and YouTube.
Yes.
And they are wonderful, guys. I know. I'll take that back. You guys are... You're okay.
Scott.
You're okay.
What'd
you
call it? I said Nick, then Scott.
No.
How dare you address me by my real name? I can't believe
leg arms.
There you go.
No.
My goodness.
You can edit that out.
No, we won't edit that. They gotta see this. But if you guys have not checked out their channel or Instagram, please check them out because it's just a blast. We got a great group of people together that are all inspirational.
Farm tubers.
Farm tubers. There we go. That's farm tubers. Isn't that a crazy, interesting way to say it?
It is.
Farm tubers.
It's been so much fun. Hung out the other week at the World Ag Expo.
We did.
And I mean, so we're like...
We were all together.
Apparently, you're going to start paying me to be your sister.
Well, it's in the works. We'll see how that goes. Anyways, guys, if you get a chance, check them out. And once again,
it's Farmway
and Beaver Vineyards.
Thanks again. Appreciate it, guys. See ya. Guess what, guys? I'm here with Tony Fast. And what does he do?
I drive truck.
He drives truck, yeah. But not necessarily just drives truck. He actually lives, about 6 hours from us?
Yep.
So he's a Montanan. We're like locals. We're basically cousins, right? I think it was Pleasance.
There's probably blood somewhere.
Yeah, definitely blood. And that kind of color blood is red. He runs a lot of Case IH stuff, which is awesome. If you haven't had a chance to check out his channel, it's awesome. He's got great content, and we've been able to get to know each other. Oh, they're turning the lights off. Oh, we better get going. But I'm sure you've seen a few of these videos of him, and if you haven't subscribed to him, please go check him out, because this is awesome. Like, the connections that we've been able to make, absolutely amazing.
Who would have thought, like, two times a year we all get to hang out together as, like, the whole YouTube community? It's been a riot.
It's, what's amazing is we actually haven't met each other. We're, like, 6 hours away, and we met at, like, Omaha, Nebraska, at FBN, and then we meet here at, like, in Texas, and that's, like, the two times I've ever met this guy, but we're, like, basically good friends. So it's it's funny how that works.
Basically good friends. We're, like,
and
besties.
When we got to the airport, we literally arrived at the same time, two different flights, and we got a car together. So
we crushed an Uber.
we crushed an Uber. Yes, it was. Yeah, I got to lose some weight. But anyways, guys, awesome. Thank you again, and thanks, Tony.
Thanks, Scott. Yeah. Leg arms.
Make up your mind.
Leg
Everybody's
arms.
Like, oh god. Okay, leg arms. Thank you, guys. Talk to you later. Guess what, guys? I am actually here with. Come on, what's your channel?
Craig?
I don't know.
Craig, yes, we're here with Craig. Right, he's
Craig's
great.
Farming videos.
Craig's farming videos. I think he runs like lawnmowers and like some small
RC tractors.
Oh, guys, this is Brian's farming videos. He is a YouTuber just like us. If you guys haven't had a chance to check out his videos, you should definitely look him up. Awesome channel. We became friends like a year ago at I had no idea who he was, and I thought he was kind of like stuck
comment.
Up, but now he's actually pretty cool.
I never get
you know?
To comment yeah. otherwise.
I bumped into this brick. I was like,
dude. Yeah. And I bumped into this like tall like toothpick, and I was like, oh man, this is like there's something wrong here. But no, we became good friends, and so anything you want to say, words of wisdom? Yes, stay in school, please. Yeah, that would be great.
Alex.
Guys, thanks. So we just had a little bit of lunch at a location with a few friends, and we are so full. He had a steak. I had some kind of chicken burger thing.
T-bone steak.
And then the dessert was probably like over 2 million calories for me, and I feel it.
Yeah.
And guess what we're going to go do? We're going to go play, and we're going to feel really sick when we do it. And maybe some fun things after that, too. But there's going to be a group of people at Top Golf that we're supposed to hang out with. So, yeah.
Just waiting on our Uber.
Yeah, Uber.
It's going to be here soon.
Oh, my goodness. It's so late. I can't wait 2 minutes. I got to step back.
Oh! All right.
Oh, that's not bad. Oh, yeah. So we went ahead and went go-kart riding, and we couldn't take the GoPros on, but it was pretty fun, pretty epic. But we couldn't go on another race because somehow the times got messed up, so we got reimbursed.
Don't race against Zach. He's a dirty, dirty cheater.
Yeah, he's your husband. Exactly. We got back from the go-karts. We took an Uber driver. Tony Fast ran with us too. He went to his hotel. And we got dropped off at the wrong location, so we got to walk to our
wrong address.
He put the wrong address. So we got to walk to our hotel this way. But it was actually pretty fun. Sorry you guys could not see the go-karts because, well, the go-karts didn't allow GoPros. So, anyways, we're heading back to the hotel and we're going to go to sleep. It's like almost 12 midnight. Yeah. Pretty sweet, guys. Okay. Act like nothing's going on, okay?
I'll block it.
Exactly. I can't see it. I don't want to look at it. I'm not gonna look at it.
Oh, no.
Oh, goodness. What is that?
I'll go.
The guy, yeah, he should go. Just go ahead. Leave. I am so disappointed in that guy right now. So disappointed. Guess what, guys? I'm here with Tony Fast. We're doing a live stream on his channel. This is really weird, guys. I just don't know what to say. All I know is Tony brought me over here. I'm kind of out of my environment, which is not a bad thing, but it just, I don't know what to think right now. So this is pretty sweet though, guys. Oh, it's like holding your breath, man. I can actually breathe now. This it never felt so good. That was scary, guys. I don't know what to say about that. It was just terrifying. You guys see that guy? And that guy over there? Yeah, they're cool guys. Check them out. I was so bummed out when one of these air drills came to our farm last spring. I wasn't there at the moment. I had to go, but man, I would love to run one of these.
just looks awesome. It's just so big. You know how much seed you could put in this thing and just keep seeding for hours and hours? Oh, that just sounds awesome. Maybe one day I'll get to run one of these. Maybe.
Finally made it back to the farm. It's been crazy. Commodity Classic was a riot. The guys there, girls, all just a fun group of people to spend time with. A lot of farmers that we met. And Case IH, thank you for bringing us out there. That was a riot. Spent some time in the Farmers Business Network booth. Had actually YouTube there too, so that was cool. But we're finally back, and it's finally time to get to work. So we're going to go to work in the next episode. All right, guys. Take care. God bless. We'll catch you in the next one. Make sure you subscribe. Thumbs up. And moving along. See ya.